to always sense of December. This is the ceremony on this day, a first question always for physics. Sorry for the chemist. But in the but if you look at the last will of Albert Nobel, the order was first physics, and then the second one was in chemistry, and the third medicine. Literature, yes, this year long literature prize, okay. Economics, and these prizes in Oslo, there's a different place. So these are the Nobel Prize ceremony in Stockholm, and the highlight is that the king gives the certificate to this situation, that the king, and then you get the medal and the certificate. So this is one of the highlights, but I think the real highlight is not the king, I think the queen is more because he's born in Germany, so therefore, as a German, I have the privilege to speak in German with her, and so we can discuss about science. Every year she has to learn something about physics normally, so she's sitting here with the Nobel Prize winner in physics normally. This is a big dinner. So this is some podcast. So for this, we have to walk in for the Nobel Prize, not to buy it. So this is a say serving at the same time coming down, at the same moment you will get your dinner plate. It's a top secret, it's a fantastic dinner. For this, one can work for the Nobel Prize. But when I got the prize, I couldn't eat it because you have to give a speech. Normally I don't like to give it in front of the audience speeches. And I was a young scholar at the high school. I always wanted to sit in the back and not to be in the center. And if somebody has told me at this time, if you study physics, you may have a chance to get the Nobel Prize, I would say, no, I will escape from this. Because when it's true, I didn't want to be in the center. But if you have the prize, you have to survive somehow. So today, I'm familiar with the situation. But as a young person, I was so nervous, I didn't like to stay in front of a big group. I cannot change. Okay, so then you have to stay there and give a speech. And this is published, you can go to the homepage of the Nobel Foundation. And I looked at one sentence I presented at the speech in 1985. And this is true, I think, and I mentioned that basic research offers the best opportunity of reaching across borders and overcoming ideological barriers to have this cooperation. And I think this is a fantastic stage for science, this international connection, this friendship everywhere in the world, even if you compete with each other. This is extra book for the dinner, and you have to learn some French to understand the menu here. This basic knowledge as you can see, café. So this is the cup with the Nobel medal here as the emblem of the coffee at the end. But remember, so if you have a Nobel Prize, you were sitting there drinking coffee, then you may ask yourself, okay, what happens after the Nobel Prize? Because if you are the peak, it can only go down. Okay, but there are some highlights for some extent, right? This is something you will never get. I'm sure, without Nobel Prize, I would not stay here. Okay, but now, the quantum Hall effect is really a very, very modern topic, even today. So I discovered this in 1980. And one indication is how many people are working in this field, how many are publishing in this field. And I looked here at the publication. So here's the publication starting in 1980, the discovery of quantum Hall effect. And here's the number of papers per year. And at present, we have two new publications per day. Every day, there's a new two new scientific publications where quantum Hall effect is in the title or in the abstract. So there's always some new phenomena, and I have here indicated many different Nobel Prizes. So I got the Nobel Prize in 1985, then the so-called fractional quantum Hall effect, an extension of this, was discovered, and then in 1998, they got the Nobel Prize. Graphene is a very modern topic, and if you look at the citation, the quantum Hall effect plays an important role. The Nobel Prize in 2016 was topology, And your quantum artifact is the guy that's the mother of all topological phenomena. And you see the number of publications, there's a strong increase, because all fields, you will find publications and you can see quantum artifact. And even here, in computational wave cosmology, you'll find publication quantum artifact. I have found this publication, gravitational quantum artifact, that the gravitational quantum artifact of gravitational wave in curved space is twice as large as it applies. I don't understand this publication. Please, no question. But even in cosmology, I saw a diploma work here about 4+1 dimensional quantum Hall effect and application to cosmology. Once more, this is not my field. I'm a semiconductor and material science physicist, and there are many, most of the books are just related to semiconductor physics. You see all the different books, each one has 500 pages, so there's many, many books just called quantum Hall effect, quantum Hall effects, because there's more than one effect. There's many, many scientific interesting question. I cannot cover this field. I will just focus on two of these books. This is a book, Introduction to Quantum Metrology, or here, Quantum Metrology. And in these books, you can find quantum Hall effect, quantum Hall effect, an important part of these books. So therefore, in my talk today, this word metrology plays an important role. It has nothing to do with climate change or this weather forecast. Metrology, metrology is the science of measurements. So metrology is science of measurements. And I want to show you this picture where a scientist is staying here and describe nature. And if you have to describe something in science, you have to measure something. You say, okay, this height, this dimension, all kinds of the weight. So you have a lot of parameter. And if you describe nature, you need only the 7 base units to describe nature. So this is all measurements, biology, chemistry, physics, all measurements can be expressed by our 7 base units, these 7 base units here, our international system of units. I think I should repeat this, that everything can be expressed by these 7 base units. We have other laws for other combinations, we have velocities or force or other things, but you can trace back everything to these 7 base units, the second for time, meter for length, kilogram for mass, Kelvin for temperature, ampere for electric current, candela for luminous intensity, and the mole for amount of substance. These are our 7 base units. So everything in our universe can be described by these 7 base units. Therefore, we need very reliable base units, so that we measure everywhere the same. And the best realization which I use today is for the kilogram, a prototype. We have still a piece of metal I'll show you later for the kilogram. The Kelvin, the temperature, is fixed by the melting point of ice, and this is absolute zero, the critical point of water. The ampere for the electrical current, if you look, what is the definition? Is defined by the force between the wires that the current is flowing. So this is today our definition. And all of them will change next year. So I will concentrate on the kilogram, but all of them, and I will show you in which way, they will change next year. So we have some established units, but they, these space units, will change in the future. And sometimes it's called the biggest revolution in metrology since the French Revolution, since 220 years, because at the French Revolution, we changed our system to the metric system and to some units that are valid everywhere in the world. So, a new SI in 2019 is a small question mark still, and I will show you why I have put a question mark, but as a scientist, I know to 99% that we will have a new international system in next year. So, but let's go back first. I mentioned to you the biggest revolution is the French Revolution on this time scale, 1799, the end of the French Revolution, was important for the metric system. It was born. 2 standards, the meter, the kilogram, were produced at this time. And these are the starting of our modern system of measurement. up to this time, they use so many different units. The foot, or the L, the cubit, or the grain for weight measurement, carat, pound. For some grains, they look so identical, and the marginal grain was used in many, many countries. But unfortunately, the English grain was this value, French grain was this one, German grain was this one. So each country has another unit. So for trade, it's impossible. And in Germany, I know we have about 140 different length units. For each city, more or less, another length unit. So you have to go to some special house to know what is the length unit in the city. And you have to pay tax then for selling something. So in 1799, the French Academy of Science, they implemented a new system. And they introduced the metric system, and then for the first time, 100,000, not 60 or other units, were used as basis for our measurement system. And they recommended and this was introduced by law, one day, 10 hours, and 1 hour, 100 minutes. But this was only valid for 2 years. Because you see here is the new one, and here to compare the old one. But the reason was, there was protest against this change by the unions. There were protests really on the street in Paris, demonstration against a change in this way. Because there fear that 1 week would be 10 days. Then you have to work longer. And you know, if somebody has to work longer, they have more than especially in France. So therefore, this is the only unit which was not in the this metric system, and we are still today in France. So this was then the final idea to produce a meter and a kilogram. And you know, the idea was since it should be valid for everyone on the earth to use something which is available on the earth. And therefore, the meter is equal to this from the North Pole to the equator. So in principle, everyone could measure this from the North Pole to the equator. And the idea was that 1 liter of water is available everywhere, should be 1 kilogram. This was a basic idea. But to realize this is so difficult. So already 1 liter of water, you have to know the temperature very accurately because the expansion coefficients are very complicated. The purity, then you need the dimension. So therefore it's much easier to have a prototype, and therefore the idea was this is the official kilogram, this is the official meter, which was connected originally to this idea. But officially this was recommended by the Academy of Science. But it took a long time to be accepted. This was 1875. The metric system was signed by 17 countries. And if I look at it, really, the Excellency, President of the United States, Majesty, Emperor of Germany, Majesty, Emperor of Austria, all of them came together in Paris, desiring the international uniformity and precision in standards of weights and measures. So this was a driving force to sign such a contract, so that we have everywhere in the world the same basis for our trade. This was the starting point of our modern measuring system. So most countries have accepted this by law, so only some red countries here, like Liberia or Burma, and you know, this is the United States, they have not accepted by law the metric system. These are the only countries, and if I come to the United States to NIST or National Bureau of Standards formally, they say, okay, we are moving inch by inch to the NIST. I can tell you, there was a big disaster. NASA lost 125 million Mars Climate Orbiter spacecraft because the different base stations use different units. And they communicated in different units, and this was mixed up. So this was not successful because of not uniformity in the units. 125 million just because they didn't use the correct unit. Now, this is distributing this, so you have really centimeter, and you can calculate teaspoon is 5 milliliter, and ounces or inches, and all the units. These are just numbers, so the accuracy is not influenced by these different systems, but I say we should use this metric system all over the world. And you know already that here in 79 or so, this was officially introduced in Jamaica. Now, the metric system in Jamaica, there's still some improvement, because when I came here on Friday, last Friday, first of all, I had a big accident. And I look here, 341 milliliter. Oh, this is a strange number. You have 341 milliliters for a beer here. This was on the 5th, this was Friday. And I was at the Standards Institute, so you know the Bureau of Standards of Jamaica, and I mentioned to them, what is this? And they told me, okay, we are moving milliliter per milliliter. Because on Sunday, or Saturday, one day later, I had a beer, 330 meters. Okay, so it's less now, so this way you, it becomes more expensive. In principle, you should know which units are used. In Europe, it's forbidden to use these odd numbers. There's only allowed 3/4 of a liter or half a liter. Or, okay, 1/3 of a liter is also allowed. But to have, okay. To a huge change. This next time I'm going to be a year, so I will only have three. So in 1875, this was really a big event. So even the president of France, he was present when the copies for all the delegates, because the delegates in 17 countries, they were to bring back a kilogram and a meter. So they make all kinds of copies here. And I know in Germany we have today, copy for the kilogram number 52, 55, and 70, and you can see all the different countries which have copies of these kilograms. And from time to time, they have to go to Paris to compare to find out what are the difference, how accurate is still the copy, the national copy. Now, if you look what is the definition of a kilogram or present international kilogram, you look in the literature, the kilogram is a unit of mass. Okay. It is equal to the mass of the international contact of kilogram. This is everything. This is the definition of all kilograms. I was telling you, sorry, this disappeared, nobody knows what a kilogram is. They added something in 48, they added another sentence after cleaning using a special method. Because there's some accumulation of some dirt. If you clean it, then you have to drop in the base. But if you clean this 10 times, then it's separating. So you're not rubbing off some material. So this was always the first question. You clean it, whether you change the material. No, there's a jump for the first cleaning. Also, at the second cleaning, you have some more time, but then it's stable. So, but they had to introduce some cleaning. Now, if you want to see the kilogram, come to Paris. Yes. Normally, you go to the Louvre or Eiffel Tower. This is the River Seine. You can walk along. This is a nice park. And at this point, yeah, this is so-called Bureau International Prime Minister. This is in the park of St. Claude, and this is this Bureau International, the BIPM, and this kilogram, the prototype kilogram, is in this building here in the setup. And I have
a film from the cannabis institute, 15 meter unter die Erde.
To show the kilogram, because there are different organizations which are responsible for weight measurements, and each organization has a key of this. And they have once a year a conference, and then key number one, key number two, key number three, they come together. And then the director of the institute, he knows the code also, and then also says, and everyone is waiting because the kilogram is still there. These are some other copies which are used normally to calibrate the national kilograms because they don't like to use the official one too often, only every 10 to 20 years, but the other one can be used once a year. Okay, so I was there, I was in steel. Because there are problems with the kilogram. I told you the different countries, they have copy of a kilogram, they go to Paris to compare. And there's a continuous drift between the copies and the prototype. So something is not stable there. So these are the measurements for 100 years. The mass of the prototype changes this time relative to the mean value of the national prototype. You don't know what is changing. You can say, oh, the 100 copies, all of them become heavier, or the prototype becomes lighter. You don't know it, because by definition, we say, okay, the prototype is official one. So this is a problem you can see in the newspaper, official prototype is killed on the seriously. Some of you would be happy, yes? Okay. But for the scientific community, I think this is not acceptable. We have something, and we have the feeling the prototype is changing, because the making procedure was slightly different than for all the copies. And we have the feeling that more gas is included in the material, diffuses out of the kilogram, so that this time and time it becomes lighter or changes more drastically the prototype than the copies. So this is a bad idea, and we have already, for 13 years, at conferences, redefining the kilogram a decision whose time has come. This was 7 years ago, and we now believe the time is ready now. At the same publication and journal was brought an electronic kilogram, and let me speak a little bit about the electronic kilogram, a new type of mass measurement. And for this electronic kilogram, I'm sure you have my Nobel Prize. So we, in 2018, we believe that we are ready to change, and it seems to be a very special year when I got a Christmas card, a New Year card from the Bureau de la National Museum that there was 2018, Merry Christmas for the New Year, and it was mentioned already here that in 2018 is expected a new definition for the core base unit of the International System of Units, the kilogram, the ampere, the Kelvin, and the mole. After 2018, the revised definition will be based for the third time on 7.6. So this was the Christmas card already, so that everyone expected that this year will be something very special. Now, who decides about it? Which group says, okay, these are our base units? There must be some organization. This is very, very old tradition. It is a special type of conference, so a general conference on base and measurement. And they meet every 4 to 6 years, normally in Paris, and they started in 1889 for this conference. Very old tradition of a conference where they discuss the best basis for our international system of units. So, and they had the last meeting in 2014, and now in 2018, in November, they have the next meeting. So here, these are the 17 countries, and I see here Jamaica joined in 2003, also this group. They will be also in the delegation this year to discuss about the future of our system. So these are all the countries which are member for this general conference. Only some African countries are missing. So they represent 98% of our industrial products, these members, these about 100 members.